Welcome to the English translation of Sozialpädagogik Debunked by Anna Geiger. Live from RC3, all talks at Congress are live translated between English and German and to one additional language. We appreciate your feedback. Please use the hashtag #C3T. Your translators for this talk are Ms. Sensei and OS10000. Anna has been a student of computer science and then she made a turn to social sciences, and she is now giving us an insight into the terminology and how it's being used and misused. Hello, good afternoon, or good morning. So this is my topic, Social Sciences Debunked. I'll explain where I'm coming from. I'll try to explain to you what it does and what it means. So it is teaching social competencies. You wouldn't be participating at this Congress, otherwise you would not have this. But many of the things that are normal to me and from day to day, they are not usual in computer science. So I don't really know where our perception differs.
Ich kann euch ein bisschen rüberbringen, was ich so, was mich so beschäftigt.
Und but I will get across what moves me, and I'll try to explain what the major things are that I find in this topic, and what others in this area find important. So it supports people in social topics, it empowers people to help themselves, and there's social work. And it does the same. It emphasizes differently.
So
social work is trying to make people, empower people to help themselves. And in practical areas, there's no difference between social work and social pedagogics. I work with both kinds.
Berufsfremden zusammen dazu, aber später mehr. Es macht in der Praxis.
There's no difference in the practical aspects.
Wo es sehr viel Unterschied.
There's a lot of difference in the history and in the theory.
Soziale Arbeit und die Sozialpädagogik kamen aus.
They were coming from different origins before they came together. Today I'm talking about the practical aspects. There's nice articles in Wikipedia on the two topics, social work and social pedagogics, if you want to learn the theory. I can only recommend it. Today I'm talking about the practical aspects. Why am I talking about all of this?
Ich euch das alles.
I had an insight. There was a talk somewhere.
Es gab, ich mir einen talk
I was watching a talk on the internet. Somebody who was programming something together with other people. And he was talking about how great it was to meet these people every week. And he was surprised by that. It was a fair and productive and good exchange, and he found that unusual. And I was surprised. Why is this unusual? For me, this is like one of the foundational things. It's normal. If you're a team, then you have to meet regularly. It happens in every team, in every institution. And for me, it's normal. And we look back and we look forward. What have we achieved? What is our next tasks?
Wenn das gut ankommt in,
but if this is being received as something that is good, received well in computing circles, then maybe I should talk more about what I find a novelty.
Ich gehe so ein bisschen durch die Themen, das wird ein bisschen wild.
I will be going through many topics.
Immer wieder in meiner Berufslaufbahn.
I've been doing this for 25 years.
Das ist
it is not complete.
Viele Themen, die ich
there will be some topics that I will leave out.
Mal los, damit ihr, wenn ihr
so was mitnehmen könnt. If I'm successful with this talk, then you will be taking something away from this to make the world a better place. So what are the practical aspects of social work? Advice.
Consulting.
People come and they want help and they need help and they request help and I advise them. Old people, family. So consulting is, you first start by finding out what the problem is. If somebody has a problem, the person may not be able to articulate it.
Das ist meine Aufgabe, das
my job finden, is to find out what the problem is and then I can advise. Sometimes I find that I cannot advise, but at least I found it out. I have one or two specialized areas of specialization. And sometimes I don't have the training. Sometimes maybe somebody needs legal advice. And in that case, I direct these people to the correct contact. Maybe somebody needs psychological advice. Then I send them to psychologists. Maybe sometimes that person doesn't get along with the government agency.
Meiner Tätigkeit einfach vermitteln zwischen
Berufen. I can be
und dann ist
ein Mitigator.
Schwerpunkt auch noch Menschen Dinge zu lehren, die sie in ihrem Alltag weiterbringen. Und das sind oft ganz banale Dinge. Das sind oft, dass ich jemanden, also was mir häufig passiert, es mag aber Zufall
sometimes
sein,
those are very normal people. What happens often is that I explain to someone how you fill in a certain
den Antrag auf Befreiung von den Rundfunkgebühren.
A certain document, a certain European document, for example.
Das lehre ich die Menschen.
Yeah, I explain it to them and I tell them that those documents don't have to be filled out perfectly, but some things have to be in it, so that in the best case they can do it the next time by themselves. But often this isn't the case. But I hope that I can take the fear from them. Sometimes I do very practical things, especially with older people. Maybe they don't have a computer at home and they have to do a transaction, and the transaction machines are difficult, and sometimes I come with them and support them, and they have to chip in all those things. It is very personal, it is very private. And after that, I will talk about later. I will talk about securing personal data.
But
yeah, if this person can't pay otherwise, then I will have to help him. And privacy is a big theme. So yes, I used gendered speech, I think, or I want to use it. It's part of my job. It's like that. And I take the liberty for myself to use it because I'm used to it. And if you have problems, so maybe if you have problems to listen it in the outside world, if I gender.
So talks, die jetzt
and there are so many other talks that are at the same time, so you can change. I don't have a problem with that, but I will keep gendering. Okay. So how does it look practically? So in the practice, someone comes into our counseling agency and yeah, we have some hygienic concepts and we are in the basement floor and yeah, people are waving, then they have to wear their mask. We do distance counseling at the moment and sometimes I also take a walk with those people. It's a very good thing. I can advise you that it's good to get to movement. And when having a walk, you can talk well. So there's someone coming to my advice agency and wants something. Ideally, the person knows what he or she wants, but this isn't always the case. And then it is my part to find out what it is with conversational techniques, which I learned in my studies and which I internalized so much that I could not say that I work after a special school or with special techniques, but I just use it. And if you ask me how I do it, it's not easy for me to explain. It's just what I do, and I just find out what the problem is. And yeah, there was a man who was in the door, very sad, and he had a bag from a discounter, and he was asking what I'm doing when there comes someone from the government who takes away my pictures. He forgot to pay things and he would have had to pay 70 euros and he was afraid that people were coming and taking away those things that he has in the worth of the money. So what's happening? I'm the one who takes away the bad feelings. He didn't have his documents with him. I didn't know why he was carrying them in the discounter bag, but sometimes they're a little strange, the people, but in a lovely way. And then we have to find solutions. Because if there's someone who is afraid that people are going to take the things from him that are important to him, and yeah, then we have to find out what's actually happening. And sometimes, yeah, there was something going wrong and it doesn't matter, but we could clear the situation with one phone call. And this is just one example from practical working. Mostly people come with some problem and we actually find out that the problem is something completely different.
Da habe ich jetzt meinen Literaturtipp, weil
here I have a literature suggestion. Maybe you are in situations where someone wants something and in the end you find out that the person wants something completely different. So maybe this is also for people who do software, who create software, and maybe the people who ask them want something completely different. Here's a book from Friedemann Schulz-Thun. It's about talking together, miteinander reden, Störungen und Klärungen. I studied social education, but I saw this book from a software developer who gives a lot of courses, and he suggested it to me because it's very pragmatic. And if someone already found out about the communication
es nicht nur darauf ankommt, was
so there are situations when you don't know, when it's not important, what do I do, and it isn't important, what are the words, but communication is not only talking, and it's a good book about it, it's a good start.
Guck da auch immer wieder mal gerne rein.
I like looking into it.
Schnörkellos.
It is very pragmatic. There are other techniques. Here's two examples. Two examples that I use myself, that I use a lot. They do good service for me.
Carl Rogers
came to fame with mirroring. I'm not sure whether you are familiar with mirroring as a term.
Ich finde sie großartig.
I find it fantastic.
Blinde sprechen, sondern allgemein. Es passiert ja manchmal, dass man irgendwie.
Sometimes you are stuck in your own thought. Eigentlich ist immer eine Lösung für irgendwas. Solution,
sei es jetzt ein Softwareproblem, sei es ein Kommunikationsproblem,
something
sei es irgendwas.
Every day or something specialized.
Kann noch nicht sein, dass ich immer im Kreis.
But you may be sort of running around in circles and not find a solution.
Dann kann man es jemand anderem erzählen und die andere Person.
And then you tell it to somebody else and that other person repeats it in different words. And then the knot is cut and it resolves itself and you find the solution. And that technique is called mirroring. You can read about this elsewhere, but Carl Rogers is the origin. And then there is somebody else, Marshall B. Rosenberg. He has something else. He's been talking with youngsters from bad homes, with from poor backgrounds, and with he's been talking about how to talk to them and create good communications. People that are not used to communicate without
violence.
Kommunikationstechniken generell. Also Marshall B. Rosenberg ist zum Beispiel.
He's very good when
Jugendlichen arbeitest, die in irgendwelchen
talking with young adults who come from poor backgrounds.
Da ist er einfach gut empfehlenswert. Es gibt aber ganz viele Kommunikationstechniken und ich kann jetzt einfach.
I cannot recommend any single one without reservation. You have to choose the right one for your target audience.
Du musst mit einer bestimmten Art von Leuten kommunizieren und du weißt, du hast da ein bisschen.
You are communicating with them and you know you've got a problem because you're not getting close. And then you should start looking for the communications technique. There's multiple ones, and there's good ones, there's bad ones. And if you find one, then use it. If there's something that surprises you and it seems esoteric, then well, just leave it out. But I guess you will get a feel for it and you'll identify them and you'll just not use them. So why have I been speaking so much and why does the whole field speak so much?
Berechtigte Frage.
It's a fair question. But it's a complicated answer. So human thinking and human behavior is very complex, and people cannot understand how this happens.
Das Denken, das Verhalten nochmal zu hinterfragen.
To reflect and look back on yourself and to rerun it before yourself is. It's not easy. So here I'm trying a comparison to computer science. I know it's a bad comparison. Maybe if you have foreign software on a foreign operating system. Don't know whether there's an operating system that you're unfamiliar with. And now this thing has an error. And now you start looking for the source of the problem, and you're not sure whether maybe it's a feature and not a bug. And that is the feeling that I have when a new client comes to me.
Dann versuche ich über Trial and Error.
And I try multiple things. I try and I make mistakes and.
Auszufinden, worum geht's denn, was denn los?
That is for me to a technique for finding the source of the problem. And it involves a lot of talking. So my job is 95% talking. And you just have to like it.
Ja, da wird doch dann geforscht an menschlichen Verhalten. Ja,
klar. And this is an area of research.
Ja, die sind total super, diese
Erkenntnisse. And I'm very happy when something new has been found out.
Dann lese ich mich da rein und dann denke ich mir, ach ja, cool, super.
Aber but it's not that easy, if only it was that easy.
Entsprechend komplex.
I've just described how complex the human operates, and similarly complex is the knowledge about this stuff. And then to document all of this is not easy either. And social research is very slow. And in a few thousand years, maybe we know more, but it is a complex topic. A thousand years ago, people didn't call it the same, but they were still researching it. And today we know a little more.
And
one of the problems is that this research is recursive. It looks at itself. So the topic being researched develops while it's being researched. There are models in social sciences. They are simplifications. And depending on the situation, different models could describe it. So I've taken three examples here that may be known already. So this describes how people communicate with each other. There's the Freud model of it, me, and the above me.
Beschrieben. Es gibt den Menschen, der sich
so there's an adult human, and he's got he or she has parts that aren't adult.
Nennen, das ist dieses, ich
will in the morning, I don't like to get up. I don't want to eat salad. And I'm feeling bad. Everything is fine. So that's the it.
So eine Elternfunktion und dieses Über-Ich, das regelt dann so ein bisschen.
And the above I is the thing that exerts some control and makes sure that I do get through the day and that I do get up in the morning and so on. So it helps to reflect on not always being an adult. It's a nice model and it describes how you have an internal dialogue. So there's a second one, which is Maslow's Pyramid of Needs.
And
that lists the needs of a human in different weighting. And it looks like a pyramid. So it is called the foundational needs of the human.
Hat den Schwerpunkt auch,
but it is emphasized in a Western socialization.
Also
so it's not fully general. But in Germany, communicating with Germans, it might be applicable. So what does this person need and what's important for them right now? These models depend on the situation. And there are there's ways of picturing the dependencies, these complex dependencies. Now something different. So Sigmund Freud is a classical reference, and without Sigmund You just don't. You can't get away with without with leaving him out.
Eine unglaublich bahnbrechende Erkenntnis und in seinen späten Jahren in einen unfassbaren Unsinn abgedriftet ist.
So. The things that he said started out well, and then they got really crazy. I see it that way, and I stick to it.
Es gab zu Sigmund Freud.
So at his time, there was something called hysterics.
Ein Oberbegriff, der sämtliche Verhaltensweisen von Frauen.
And that was a summary of women's behavior that that didn't meet the expectations of a woman at the time.
Unter anderem wurde aber auch unter Hysterie ein
at the same time under that name
something
was summed up that is a collection of symptoms
ganz speziell der
which is a post-traumatic stress syndrome
nach sexualisierter Gewalt.
So I don't want to enter into this topic much further.
Diesen Symptomkomplex, der wurde unter anderem auch unter dem Oberbegriff
that wurde einfach mit eingeworfen. Real and today well-researched topic was included in
der erste,
that topic.
Der das erkannt hat. Der hat
and he observed it.
Bahnbrechendes
at his time, it was a real breakthrough.
Der Mensch ist sämtliche Emotionen, sämtliche Verhaltensrepertoire.
So the human has a collection of reactions.
Angeboren und als Erwachsene kann einzig und allein steuern.
And an adult can, to some degree, control how much he suppresses it. And he's been working a lot with women and a lot with women that have been subject to violence.
Diese Verhaltensweisen, die sind nicht angeboren. Diese Frauen haben diese Probleme, die sie haben.
And he observed that women have this problem because it was caused by
und das war
something that happened in the past,
und der wurde
and he was ridiculed.
Und hat dann noch was gemacht. Der hatte dann echt eine
and then he had an insight.
Da kämpfen wir heute in der Sozialarbeit noch um dieses Thema. Und zwar
and then he called it, then he pointed out that men also have this.
So this traumatic syndrome after sexualized violence, that is also in men. And he said, it may be that it is in women, but it is also in women, and you have to take this serious. Many of his clients went away. They stayed away, many because they couldn't pay themselves, and he realized that the human being is developing through what he has in his life, and this is so was so new that you cannot not mention it in social education. And he did this model of the it, I, and over I, which it's very important, and then he drifted away in theories and symbolics about
phallic
symbols and that the woman is envying the man of his phallus, and I don't know how it happened that those theories appeared. Maybe he was under pressure, maybe he survived himself sexual violence. So that he built himself such a fantasy world. And yeah, it was usual in his time and in his social stand. And yeah, at some time he just drifted away. And if someone tells you about these phallus symbols, phallus envy, you don't have to take it for serious, but the rest, yes. Then there's another one, Paul Watzlawick. He wrote a book which is called Introduction to Being Unhappy, Anleitung zum Unglücklichsein. Maybe you read it, it's very usual in nerd circles, maybe you have already read it.
nicht zum Ziel führt.
And he's talking about behaviors that don't bring you to the aim, but which people do anyways. And how people complicated themselves and how you can behave in a different way. So there's the story with the hammer. It is a story which I heard like 2 times in my first years of my studies. I heard it about 10 times when I was ready with my studies. And I asked myself if there are other stories. I've been working over 20 years and I can't listen to this story anymore, but it's good, but I can't listen to it anymore. So if you have someone in your beyond your friends and you want to you can read the story to him, he will be annoyed. But the book Anleitung zum Unglücklichsein, Introduction to Being Unhappy, this, I see this many times, and I don't have so much time to talk about all of this, but the story of more of it's of the same. I like it, and there's a Wikipedia article about this book. You can read this, or you can read the book. So, what about misunderstandings? Communication is misunderstanding. This is something general and doesn't matter which theory or schools, or if you're talking about psychology or social education, you will have misunderstandings. And many professors said a lot of your work will be uncovering misunderstandings. Do you know the word good hunger? Something we say in Germany. So hunger is something you have when you haven't eaten in a long time. And when someone said to me the first time, good hunger, I didn't know what they want to say. I know it is good appetite. Then another word, bockig. In Bavaria, you use this word for someone who is stubborn, who doesn't want to do something, and in some very small areas in Bavaria, you use it in another context. Next word, duselig. It has 2 different meanings, maybe more. I only know 2. One is not having had enough sleep, and the other is have drunken too much alcohol. We don't have to talk about the Pfannkuchen, which means like pancake and some other things you eat in Germany, and we don't have to talk about whether Brussels sprouts are something nice or not. So there are also a few words that are used misunderstandingly
in Themen. Ich versuch's mal.
Well, I will talk faster because I'm not on my time. So there's the word normal. When you see someone and you say he's not normal, this is something stigmatizing. And in social education, in social research, normal doesn't have such a stigmatizing component. But it, you talk about the norm area, and you have like those, this is normal, what is in this normal area. So like all people who are in this, on this Congress, we're not all normal, because it is not normal. We don't meet all the norms. The educational norm is probably lower as the one of the people here. If you see it on the entire society, many things are not in the norm. Dann sind but wir alle normal. If we look im Sinne on des just the people of the Congress, then we are all normal in this Congress. And if there is outside a person who says you're not normal, then this is a person which is so outside that they can't put your normality in place. Then there's a topic with very much misunderstandings, which is depression versus depression is a psychological problem. It is a big problem for the people who are depressed. And if people, normal people talk about depressions, often they don't mean the psychological problem, but they say, I'm depressive because they have a bad day. And this is not the problem, but I see even in the in the work, by professionals, they use this word depression in a wrong way, and I really hate this. The next misunderstanding is autism is not a symptom.
Egal, Autismus ist eben keine Krankheit. Und Autismus wird sehr oft missverstanden.
And many people say it is an illness, but I say many people it's not an illness. An autistic person once said autism is maybe a little like a pregnancy. It's something that doesn't have to cause problems, but it can. And the difference with autism is it doesn't end. Then we have a lot of words for people working in the psychological field. I will talk about them shortly. A psychologist is someone who knows, who studied the theory of the psyche of the human being. It is studies. It is much mathematics, and if you ended these studies, you know very much about the psyche of the human being, but this knowledge isn't practical.
Doch natürlich, aber nicht in der Praxis.
Then you need another apprenticeship, and this is for psychotherapists, and this is to really help people. This name is we have like a psychological psychotherapist as a professional name who have this apprenticeship. Others may be good too, but a psychotherapist is actually the one who has the practical knowledge and is good. Then they are psychiatrists. They work on the medical field that concern the psychics of a human. It is about the medicine that you can take if you have a psychic illness, and psychiatrists studied medicine and therefore can give you medicine too. And then there are neurologists, and those are people who studied medicine who specialize in neural illnesses.
So,
people have a lot of neurons in their body, and therefore neurologists are often important, and they can change the person's psyche, but it's a different deal. I could talk much more, but I don't want to start another theme, and I would like to end here. And if you have questions, you can ask them now.
Maybe
I find the last slide. There's the email address. And then can I show it to you?
E-Mail-Adresse, ich sag's dir euch einfach, weil
I will tell it to you.
Ich bin zu doof, bin meinen Computer zu bedienen. Meine E-Mail-Adresse ist anna@geiger.wtf. anna@geiger.wtf und es ist ziemlich cool
vor Leuten. And it's very cool to talk in front of people who don't want to ask.
Dankeschön.
Anna, thank you.
Vielen lieben Dank.
Many thanks for your talk.
Ich habe hier als Herold.
As the Herald, I have questions from the chat.
Chat aufgelaufen sind.
Ich höre niemanden. I don't hear anyone.
Ja, genau. Ich habe hier ein paar Fragen, die hier im Chat aufgelaufen sind.
First question from the chat.
Die erste Frage. Denkst du, dass eine Art Sozialgeheimnis, wie zum Beispiel das Bankgeheimnis für soziale Arbeit...
Do you think that it would be possible to have a social secret, just like there's a banking secret? Let me think about that one. Also, yes, no, nein, maybe. Nee, I wouldn't want to make it complicated.
Jede Regelung,
every rule brings a problem, and I work here with a data protection officer.
Ich habe mich tatsächlich mit dem Thema intensiver auseinandergesetzt, obwohl ich jetzt nur für
I can only talk for my small area.
Zuständig bin. Wir dokumentieren in der Sozialarbeit
grundsätzlich We document so as little as possible.
Ich hätte auch eine Slide dazu, aber das hat jetzt einfach zu weit geführt. Wir haben das so internalisiert.
We practice it from the beginning,
vom ersten Semester,
from the first hour, that we record as little as possible. And even towards the people who pay, our justifications are to record as little as possible.
Kostenträger, also
depending on what we do,
auch in Stellen, die unsere Arbeit
they finance us,
Sozialarbeit finanzieren, die relativ detailliert nach einem relativ
and it's a clear grid
möchten und da kostet uns das viel
and it costs us a lot of time
möglichst neutral zu bleiben, aber das ist einfach das
to stay within that.
In uns
we don't need any extra rules.
Ja. Eine weitere Frage. Jemand fragt, kennst du Konzepte
Do you know concepts for coping with trauma from games?
Also gibt es da Spiele?
Do you know how to cope with trauma by using games?
Well,
it's not my topic, but I think there is something that I don't have any pointers. Please send me an email. I will get myself informed. And if I find something, I'll let you know.
Dann habe ich noch einige
Here's more questions to generally software.
Software-Welt noch mal so. Erstmal, welche Kommunikationskanäle benutzt du?
How do you use communication? What do you use? Mail? Do you chat messengers? Do you use the telephone?
Und wird dann da auch
And is it encrypted?
Verwendet? Also zum Beispiel in einem Messenger oder so.
Ja. In theory.
Also ich gehe grundsätzlich mal davon aus, es ist auch
It's a big
ein
topic.
Großes Thema und es war jetzt gerade zu Anfang
And at COVID, suddenly
plötzlich schlagartig
we had to move everything on to online.
Erstmal gehen wir
We have to keep it simple.
Wir müssen vor
allem We have to reach those people. People who have problems because maybe
nicht gut gebildet
they don't have the education or the Simply, they don't cope with this.
And
we are a lot on the telephone. It seems a safe option. We do offer encrypted channels. If somebody accepts it, that's great, and we like it. But if somebody says, no, this is too complicated, I need to talk now,
dann ist das
Then talking now is more important.
Und ganz bemerkenswert, ich habe zum Teil mit Frauen zu tun, die sind
Sometimes I talk to women that are between 75 and 90
neulich mir
erzählt, and they are meeting via Jitsi.
Weil alles andere ist Quark, weil das Jitsi ist in
Because Jitsi is safe. And I was really surprised and I really enjoyed that information.
Noch eine Frage. Welche Hardware und Software
What software and hardware do you use in your everyday life? Are there open source tools that you use? No.
Nö.
I'd like it.
Hätte ich gerne.
I'd like to have more influence on this.
Wir haben einen, nicht, dass ich es jetzt falsch wiedergebe, wir haben ein, ich habe, ja, also sitze an einem.
I'm sitting at an Eagle thin client, I see a Windows, I have no influence on this.
Das ist so. Wir arbeiten, wenn wir beraten,
when we consult, Red Connect, then we use NetConnect as a software.
Software. Oder aber mit
or whatever the people can use.
Letzte Frage.
Last question, I'm not so sure myself.
Da kenne ich den Begriff gar nicht. Was hältst du von
what do you think of social informatics? That's a new term for me. If it is true, if it exists, then that's great. I would envision it as a combination of social science and computer science. Give me more information if you have it, whoever you were. You have the email address of Anna.
Fragt sie gerne.
Please ask her, and we will give the link into the chat. So ask her in the break, and we thank you. Thank you, Anna.
Bei Anna für den Vortrag.
And we also thank the audience.
Hier im Chaos Zone TV.
And talk to you next time. Thank you. Ciao. Bye.